Hello 12th class students, this is your chapter 15, your lecture number 2. In the previous class, you learned how to connect MySQL with Python. In this class, you will learn about parameterized queries and its methods. So, parameterized query, you can easily understand by this sentence that parameterized query means the query that is run with the help of the parameter. When we pass the parameter, then that particular query will run. So in this we passed a parameter, and you know what is parameter. You already learned a function. So in functions we had talked about the parameters. So here I recall this, that what is parameter. So in parameter we pass a value, or we can say an argument, to that particular function, so that function, when the function will get executed, this particular parameter will take as a value. So in this, when we pass the value to the query to perform the dynamic search, like we want to search for an employee number entered during runtime, or to search any other column values. So in this, why we need this parameter? If we want to search any employee number, then we have to pass a variable to the user that this is the employee number, and we have to search according to that. That's why we need a parameter. So to create a parameterized query, we can use the various methods like concatenating dynamic variables to query in which values are entered, string template with percentage formatting, string template with curly braces and format function. So these are the three methods to create parameterized query. Now we will discuss each one by one. So first, concatenating variable with query. You can see a Python code is written here, and then corresponding output is there. So first we need to understand what this code says. Import mysql.connector as my. So this is a package that we are importing, mysql.connector. We are giving an alias name my. Now mycon, this is a connection object. In this we are connecting the object where to host, that is localhost. User is your root, password is admin, and database is your company. Now my cursor is equal to mycon.cursor. We are creating our cursor. The name of the cursor is my cursor, and then we are executing our queries accordingly. So mycon.cursor is the function where we are executing the query. Now e is a variable which store the employee number that we want to search, and it is an integer form. Now query is equal to select string from emp, where emp number is equal to plus stre. So here you can see the plus symbol is there. Plus is used to concatenate the variables. Now we are changing this integer into the str. Then we are executing our query. Data is equal to mycursor.fetch. So here we are just fetching only one query. That's why we use this fetch one function. If data is not equal to none, then print data. Else print no such employee number. This message will come. So here when we enter 1, then it will give the result according to employee number 1. Again we have run this program. Then we pressed 6. So 6 for 6, no employee exists. So that the message comes, no such employee number. So this is the program that how will you concatenate the variable with the query. So you have to remember this plus symbol. Then you have to convert if it is an integer into a string, so that the particular result will get executed. Next is string template with percentage s formatting. Now in this method, we will use percentage s in place of values to substitute, and then pass the value for that place. Now see, this is the code. Import mysql.connector. It is a package. this mic on, this is your connection object, this is your my cursor for executing SQL queries. Now E is a variable where you want to search the employee number. Now query is equal to select asterisk from EMP, where EMP number is equal to percent S. Now you here you do not use any comma, you have to just use percentage then tuple E. Okay, we are taking it as a tuple. So you can see here one comma is there, means one element is there in this tuple. So this query will get executed and the remaining code is same. So whenever you are using this string template with percentage s formatting, then you have to use it with tuple. So you have to remember this. So when you will run this program, then this particular output will come. Okay, so you have to just remember this percentage s. So whatever the value is there, it is just passed to this variable. Okay, now next is again percentage s formatting. Here if you want to search an element by passing two parameters, then how will you use? So again import mysql.connector. So this is the package, then connection object you have to establish, then my cursor function will get called. Now D is equal to input enter department to search, then S equal to input enter value to start salary search. So here you are passing two variable D and S. Now select asterisk from EMP, where department is equal to percent S and salary is greater than equal to percent S. Now you are passing the parameter percent D comma S comma. So D, it will take it as a department number, and for S it is taken as a salary. Okay, so by this way you can pass any arguments or you can pass any parameter. So D and S value, it will take it accordingly. Okay, so this value will be passed to this variable and this S variable will pass to the percentage S salary variable. Then you have to execute the query. Then data is equal to my cursor dot fetch all, then it is fetching all the data. Now n record is equal to my cursor dot row count, it will count the rows. Then print total record fetched are this, it will count. Then if n record is not equal to 0, then it will run the if the condition is true, then it will goes in the for loop for row in data, print row. And if the condition is wrong, or we can say false, then it will just print the else part, that is sorry, no such employee. Okay, so when you will run this, so this is your data and now this is the output. So enter department to search, this is IT, IT is your department. So enter value to start salary search, that is 50,000. So in this, the value that is greater than 50,000, this is IT. Okay, this condition means both the result will come. So that total result record fetched are 2. That's why the result will come here. Okay, you are printing it. So this condition is true, that's why these two row will come. Again you are entering IT and then you are entering the value 70,000, the value of salary 70,000, so that only one result will come. Now again you are calling the department IT, searching the department IT, and you are entering the value 50,000. So this is 5 flag, so it is not showing you any output. So the message will come, sorry, no such employee. Okay, now next is string template with curly braces and format function. So in this method, in place of percentage s, we will use the curly braces and we have to pass the value for these placeholder. Then we have to use dot format function. Okay, now this 0, 1, these are just the index number, but it is not mandatory. We can also optionally pass the named parameter inside it. So that while passing the value through format function, we need not to remember the order of the value passed. For example, this roll number, name, marks. Okay. Rather than passing 0 and 1, we can also pass the variable 0, roll number, name, etc. Now see the program. String template with curly braces and format function. Import mysql.connector. This is a package. Then you are establishing a connection object. Then you are calling the cursor function. Now D is equal to input, enter department. Then S is equal to input, enter salary. You have to enter the salary. Then what is the query? Select asterisk from employee where department is equal to this debt and salary is greater than equal to salary. You are again passing the parameter within curly braces. And then dot format. What is the format? That salary is equal to S and department is equal to D. So whatever the value you are passing here, this will pass to these variables, salary and department. Because we are passing here the variable debt and the salary. Okay. Then you have to execute the query. Then data is equal to my cursor dot fetch all. You have to fetch all the record. That's why you have to use the fetch all function. Now you have to count the total number of rows. Then you have to use the row count function. Okay. The same program is as the previous one. So you can see that. So when you run it, enter department HR, enter salary 50,000. So total record fetched are 2. Okay, so it will give you the result. Okay, when again you will run, then it will give you only 1. Then again you will run it, then it will give you 0 employee. So this is the program that is a string template with curly braces and format function. So for this class, it is just ended here. So what is your homework? You have to do practice these Python programs. Then you have to revise your classwork. You have to make notes and you have to submit your notes on my mail ID or you can WhatsApp me. Okay, so just revise your lecture. So thank you and have a nice day.